Welcome to the battery replacement tutorial for the GX680 Film Back. There are six screws to remove. The first two on the back by the open lever are longer than the others. Two on each side. These are on the blank side. Two on the side with the dark slide. You can either remove the dark slide to make it easier to get to, or flip the handle out of the way to remove the screws. The knob at the top is actually a screw. That center part will rotate. You just have to figure out kind of how to get grip on it, and then it just unscrews. The plastic piece below it just comes right on out. Don't worry about orientation, it is keyed. Next, we want to go ahead and open the back. Just bring down the lever until it pops and then swing it open. We want to remove the film holder. Just squeeze the two levers in the center there and then pull out. You can now separate the back. Just wiggle it and it should come loose. There are no hidden snaps. You will find it easier if the lock is clicked all the way down. On the side, you'll find the battery you need to remove. For this part, you'll need a soldering iron and solder. Some wick and solder sucker can help clean up the excess. In mine, the battery was adhered to the plastic with tape. I recommend lifting it off first before desoldering, then just desolder the battery legs. Because I didn't remove the tape first, I apply heat for too long and remove the pin that the battery tab was soldered to. I simply clean the battery and reattach the pin. To solder the new battery, I made sure the direction or polarity of the battery was correct by referencing a photo I took prior to removing the old battery. In this view, positive is on the left side of the screen, with negative being on the right, nearest that large circular speaker slash beeper. The tab was held to the pin, and solder was applied to the iron, then the joint. For the other tab, I bent it into place and repeated the soldering. The finished soldering job is not great, but contact is made and the connection appears strong enough. We can test if the battery is working by holding down the bottom call button and making sure the screen displays. Now we just put the unit back together by putting the back plastic door assembly back on, making sure the opening lever is all the way down. Snap the back into place. Return the knob by putting the plastic piece on until it locks into the keyed position, then put the screw back in. The remainder is putting the rest of the screws in, remembering the longer ones go by the door opening lever. As an added step, I create a label with the date the battery was changed. The area was cleaned with an isopropyl alcohol swab and let to air dry prior to applying the label. It is finished! The back now successfully remembers how many exposures were taken even if the camera has power removed or the back is taken off of the camera. In this example, we are on exposure 2. Removing the back, the call button still works and it shows the correct number. To remove the film back from the camera, insert the dark slide into the back. Press the revolve button and turn anti-clockwise 45 degrees. The back will now free itself to pull straight off. Hopefully that was helpful. If so, go ahead and leave a like. Make sure you are subscribed for more camera and tech videos, and leave a comment if you have any questions. I'll try and help. Thanks!